35 scientists from 5 countries explore an important climatic phenomenon in the Arctic, ocean acidification. During a field experiment, they investigate the impact of the change in ocean chemistry on the marine community. The research is conducted under the umbrella of the European Project on Ocean Acidification, EPOCA. Carbon dioxide emissions not only lead to global warming, they also cause fundamental changes in the ocean. The sea absorbs about one-third of human-generated CO2. In water, the gas forms carbonic acid, which makes seawater more acidic. Corals, mussels and snails, but even the tiny planktonic organisms, will experience difficulties building their shells. Many of them play important roles in the marine ecosystem. They provide the foundation of the marine food web. Their metabolism influences the gas exchange between the surface of the ocean and the atmosphere. The researchers have set up their laboratories at Ny-Arlesund on the western coast of Svalbard. The village, reserved for research only, is located at a scientific hotspot. The Arctic is threatened by ocean acidification more than any other region. One of the reasons is that the cold water of high latitudes takes up more CO2 than warm water. Ocean acidification therefore hits the Arctic faster and stronger than warmer regions. The environmental organization Greenpeace supported the scientists by transporting the equipment to Svalbard. At the beginning of June 2010, 9 so-called mesocosms, giant test tubes, were placed in the fjord. We've now placed the mesocosms at their final position and will anchor them at the sea floor. When all 9 mesocosms are deployed, the bags which are still tied up at the top will be lowered, thereby cutting out a water column of 15 meters depth and enclosing all the organisms swimming in the water right now. Divers ensure that the buoyancy frames are tied properly and the bottom plates are closed. After setting up the mesocosms, the researchers measure the water temperature, salinity, oxygen, pH, density, turbidity and chlorophyll concentration daily. We do CTD profiles every day because it's a good way to check the mesocosms' overall performance. This way we'll detect leakages quickly, for example by salinity changes. It's therefore important to check daily what things look like. With the so-called spider, carbon dioxide-enriched water is added to the isolated worlds. In doing so, the scientists simulate the future ocean in their mesocosms. When the mesocosms have reached their target CO2 levels, the sampling starts. About 300 liters of water are processed every day for on-site measurements and later analyses in the home laboratories. A clear signal emerges already during the course of the experiment. The Arctic ecosystem responds more strongly to a rising CO2 level than previously expected. The consequences are most obvious at the base of the food web, with carry-on effects to higher trophic levels. With humans at the top end of this food web, the impacts of ocean acidification may soon be felt by us.